Hi, I'm George Tsypin, the set designer for Spider-Man Turn of the Dark. I studied architecture in Moscow. I have 2 degrees in architecture and set design from NYU. Mostly I design opera, but I've done many, many other things. I worked with Cirque du Soleil. I've done a lot of big events. I also sculpt, and I've done gallery shows. So I always try to do something new. When you design in bigger spaces, let's say Metropolitan Opera, where there is a lot of space, it's much easier. Broadway, even though it's one of the biggest theaters on Broadway, it's still very small. And especially to create all these effects, we have to renovate the theater, and I wanted to open up the proscenium to eliminate the barrier between the stage and the house, and not only visually, but also in order to have that flying through the proscenium, so it doesn't feel like they're flying through a little opening. All of that takes unbelievable amount of time. Very early, I had an idea that I will take graphic quality of comic books and try to explode it into space, make it dimensional. And then, of course, pop-up books immediately came to mind, and I already was inspired by a lot of pop-up books, because right now there is an explosion of pop-up books, and I just wanted to show some of the books. For example, this book is very abstract. It has no text, nothing. It's just, spatial sculpture. And it's just so beautiful. This is, by the way, this is one of pop-ups I was inspired by in the very beginning. And I just wanted this, kind of abstract sculpture. But of course, we have to tell the story. So something like this inspired the set of the high school, unfortunately. It doesn't function here, but in the show, first you just see the flat image of the school, and then the classroom sort of explodes out of that flat image, and the kids are, some of them are graphic, and then real actors appear here, and then more real actors downstage of that, and all of that happens quite fast, and it creates the very, very unique language of telling the story. I also wanted to show this book, which was also one of the early inspirations on Hitchcock, and how the story is told with this wild collages in space and little details and close up, and we tried very much to capture this language. It's such a joy. The story is inspiring. We're all very small kids inside. Every single small kid, weak kid, a man wants to be powerful, wants to fly. And of course, it's a metaphor for greatness. I wanted the audience feel like they're Spider-Man, as if they actually looking at New York from Spider-Man point of view, and feel the same vertigo, as if they're flying. Your heart should stop, because not only you see the actor doing something amazing, the whole world is flying around you.